O'Neal Give 'Em Hell Bell is a destructive power puncher. Dale Cowboy Brown is a well-groomed smart boxer. It's a classic matchup for the IBF Cruiserweight World Title. A look at the ESPN.com rankings detail how entrenched these two men are among the best 200-pounders. Bell's number 4, while Brown's 5-fight win streak has him atop 7. This is O'Neal Bell's 26th fight. Only one has gone the full distance. We have seen him rip through the best, like when he knocked out the then soon-to-be champ, Kelvin Concrete Davis. More recently, Bell obliterated Derek Harmon with a vicious display of skill and force. Those were just two names added to the list of hunted down trophies. Former champ Arthur Williams and title challenger Ezra Zellers have also felt Bell's power. Now he meets up with Calgary's Dale Brown, a dedicated pro who has fought for the world title twice before. Since his last title shot loss, he's been impressive. He beat down the power-punching Richie LaMontagne in summer 2003. Then this past February, he quickly discarded Shelby Gross, who was grossly overmatched. A closer look at Dale's career shows that he toppled former world champ Robert Daniels, but his three losses were by KOs to world champs Giroff, Braithwaite, and Jean-Marc Ormec. Dale says he has solved that problem with the most intense training camp he's ever had. Bell says he'll beat Dale at his own game.
They're fitting this fight to be a boxer versus a puncher, but I want to beat the man at his best style ever, so I'd box a boxer. You know, quicker hands. Definitely have the power. Let my hands go. The knockout will come.
Well, I think he has to be a little bit more apprehensive coming in. He's not going to come in lunging at me because I'm just going to slip and make him pay. That's our game plan. Anyway, we're going to box him very early. We're not going to get into trades with O'Neal. We know that he's strong. We know that he can punch. His record stands to tell us that.
IBF title on the line. Two men whose careers intersect tonight. O'Neal Bell, Dale Cowboy Brown, and there is O'Neal Bell. He was supposed to fight for this version of the world title in February, but Kelvin Davis vacated the belt. That was due to promotional issues. He's 30 years old. He gets that golden opportunity now 3 months later. He's been patiently awaiting this night. 6'2", 199 pounds, and he can flat out bang. His last five, all knockout wins. Hasn't fought since September. That was against Ezra Zellers. And his average fight doesn't go past five rounds. And for the third time in his career, Dale Brown is fighting for a world title belt. Boxing's his life's passion. His mom is a judge and a boxing official back in Canada. 6'1", he's 33 years old, checked in at 198 and three quarters. His last five, all wins. And all five of these fights came right after his title shot loss to the current Ring Magazine WBC, WBA champ, Jean-Marc Ormec. Dale Brown says, I'm going to do what I do best. I will box. I'll make O'Neal Bell apprehensive, and my jab will be there all night long. You heard O'Neal Bell moments ago say, I will outbox the boxer. He was born in Jamaica. He moved to Delaware, finally landed in Atlanta. And he was an all-state wrestling star in high school. Then he took up boxing, had a limited amateur career. But his sensational physical tools have gotten him to this point, a dedicated, dedicated professional who's been learning on the job, and boy, has he ever. The gold records at the Hard Rock adorning this gentlemen, spectacular facility, but it's a belt that is the top prize tonight.
Protect yourself at all times. Do not make me pull you guys apart, okay? No unsportsmanlike conduct. Is that clear? Good luck. Touch gloves. May the best man win.
Armando Garcia laying down the law early on. The ring experience. Dale Brown has fought 11 more pro fights. He's put in over 100 more pro rounds. He's fought five former or current world champs. The other experience of note is that he's 0-2 in his experiences of fighting for the world title. But Kevin Kelly, you were with me yesterday
right
when
here.
He turned to us and said,
right here.
The difference now is that I went away for training camp. I left Calgary. I went to Vegas. I had the best camp I've ever had.
Well, that can make a difference. Preparation is everything. I mean, I live in Vegas, and I can see the difference. I mean, you got top quality sparring in Vegas. Every fighter's in Vegas, from Mayweather to Corrales to all the heavyweights, Bird, Ruiz, they all live there. So the quality opposition in the gym is incredible. Your sparring prepares you. But the point is, still, the fight is a pinch touch different because he's not sparring with O'Neal Bell. He's making caliber opposition like maybe he's Vasily Jurov in the gym. He might be doing Virgil Hill in the gym. So he's getting caliber opposition. So we'll know in the after, if it goes longer than the first round with a guy like Give Him Hell, that we'll know if he can further, you know, accomplish what he wants to accomplish here tonight.
O'Neal Bell, you saw the power numbers, 88% knockout ratio. Three first-round knockouts in his career. Brown actually has five. But Brown has a good sense of who he is. Wants to box and give angles and make sure the jab exists throughout the evening.
They call the arm now.
What actually might help Dale Brown, actually might help him, is that O'Neal said he wants to box. So, you know, it's easier to somebody to box you than just a knockout artist like O'Neal. Because O'Neal's a knockout artist. So usually he comes forward and tries to get you out of there. So that gives Dale Brown more of an opportunity to actually maybe win, try to win a fight. As long as that lasts. You know what I'm saying? O'Neal Bell
fires off a right hand and then doubles up a left to the body. Bell returns. Overhand right attempted, but muddled up by Brown. There's that jab. It's so important to Dale Brown. O'Neal Bell says speed is power and I have both. Saw what he did to Derek Harmon. He outboxed him early and then just broke him down and finished him off.
There was the one thing you haven't seen, he says he's on a box, but I don't see much of a jab that he's shooting. Not a jab with any kind of conviction. He throws the overhand right, but he's off balance when he throws it. You see him, he throws the right hand, doesn't come back with a jab or a hook. So it leaves him off balance. See, there he goes again, right off balance. He throws the overhand right, and he's off balance when he throws it. And Dale Brown should capitalize when he does that.
See if he can get a counter opportunity here as this fight develops from what you picked up early on here, Kevin. Straight right to the body for Dale Brown. Body shot right hand comes in from O'Neal Bell. And
let's
Kevin Kelly,
now.
If the subsequent rounds after this first round go this way, this is the kind of evening that Dale Brown would be looking for, is it not?
That's what he's looking for. He wants to box the whole night.
Time. Round number two of the IBF Cruiserweight title fight here on Friday Night Fights, presented by AutoZone. O'Neal Bell in the purple trunks, Dale Brown wearing the black with red trim. There's that overhand right. Seeing abrasion in the middle of the forehead of Dale Brown.
I believe it's bleeding. Some blood's trickling down from it, I believe. Yes, it
yes, there is now blood coming down right between the eyes. So it's something we will take a look at, see if that blood starts to get in the eyes. It's in a very interesting position, in the middle of the forehead.
Yeah, it's not interfering with his eyesight, so it's not in danger of stopping the fight, but it could open up and get wider. So interesting to see O'Neal Bell boxing here. Trying to put a box display on.
But Kev, why?
It's kind of awkward.
Why?
I believe he's trying to show a different, yeah, show adversity, like you said, trying to do something different, something he hasn't done. If he feels he can win this fight doing this, he's trying to prove something to himself. I don't think it's the right time or place.
Why do you need the challenge? Why do you need to challenge yourself at a moment when the IBF title is on the line, unless he's trying to draw Dale Brown into having some false confidence, which would open up some opportunities in the middle and later rounds?
I don't understand his reasoning. I can't allow anyone to lie and say this. I think they look very awkward, very unorthodox, trying to box Dale Brown. Dale Brown is a little bit more seasoned at this. You see his movement. He's getting hit with certain shots, but O'Neal's balance looks really off.
Of course, there's more room for error with O'Neal Bell. He can change the fight with one punch.
But he's getting hit right there. Overhand
right comes in that time.
And he paid attention to that. Trust me, he grabbed the cowboy real fast. And he paid attention to that shot. Brown can punch first. I mean, it ain't like O'Neal Bell has all the knockout power. So Brown does got to see when he punches. And he's in boxing format. So, of course, he's got a great snap on his shots. This is what he does. So, actually, Bell is falling into the victim into Cowboy Brown's fight. I mean, O'Neal Bell is not doing himself any justice here as a champion. Look at that. He throws the overhand right, and he turns southpaw almost. He's off balance. His footwork's not right.
Punch out of there.
You know, I'm just a matter of time, I think, before he resorts to what he normally does, because I don't believe this is working out for him. I gave him the first round, but I don't believe he's exceptionally sharp-looking and trying to win his title.
You gave O'Neal Bell the first round.
I gave him the first round.
Really? I like Brown in that first round.
You know, but I like Brown in this round, to tell you the truth.
And a round number two, Joe Tessitore and Kevin Kelly filling in for Teddy Atlas this week. Kevin, you've been in this exact position before, fighting for a world title. What goes through the fighter's mind early on? Is there that extra pressure that everybody talks about?
It depends if you put it on yourself. You know, the problem that I had winning my first world title was that I was supposed to be champion already. I didn't win a world title until I was 36-0. And I was undefeated, so I was supposed to be champion, but I was fighting a guy that was champion. So I felt like I was champion of the world. And I said, what if I don't win the world title? Ain't this bizarre?
You applied that pressure to yourself.
So I applied the pressure to myself. And then I won the title. I was happy when it was done. And I went on to have title defenses and become victorious. But I actually liked it better winning my second world title because nobody believes I can win. The odds were against me for a change. And that is better. Adversity, overcome adversity. That's where it's at.
Let me have you switch mindsets here and go from fighter to trainer. If you were in each of these corners, what would you be saying right now to these
two? I would tell Dale Brown, take advantage of what O'Neal Bell's trying to do. Utilize your jab. Keep boxing him. Keep O'Neal Bell at the end of your jab. Keep him on the outside. Don't let him get on the inside. And when he gets on the inside, tie him up so he didn't get none of that power off. And if I was O'Neal Bell's trainer, I'd tell him, listen, I know you wanted to go out there and try to beat him at his own fight. But if I was you, throw a jab, step it behind the jab, and punch to the body, and slow down the Cowboy.
Well, the Cowboy, you saw, was cut early on in round number two. And the referee, Armando Garcia, is saying that that was caused by a punch.
No, punch on, you're holding
it. It seems like that cut is well under control. You talked about the fact it was bleeding, but nothing that was going into the eyes. Bob Miller, the fine cut man in the corner of Dale Brown, able to handle that. After the second round had finished up, there's O'Neal Bell now charging behind that jab and then digs to the body. You know what's interesting is in preparing for this fight, one of the things we looked at was the cut men. And obviously Bob Miller doing a good job for Dale Brown.
O'Neal Bell is hurt
tables.
Right now. He
turned the tables
right.
There.
No, he is hurt. His legs are wobbly right now. He got hit with an overhand right. Look, he's not reacting right. Dale Brown,
I agree with you. Leaning
right
up against the ropes.
Got a chance to knock out O'Neal Bell. Can you believe this? I mean, the turn of events, the puncher got hit with a shot. Oh, my God.
Looping right hand from Dale Brown. Bell was against the ropes for a few moments there. There's another right hand that comes in. Let's see if Dale Brown can take advantage.
O'Neal Bell's legs does not look right. His legs kind of look clunky. Like I said, his balance looks off right now. He's getting,
You saw it again. Another right hand snapped out from Cowboy.
Look at his legs. His legs have locked. O'Neal Bell's legs are locked. I tell you, he has no bend.
No bounce. No bounce.
Who knows what happened before this fight? I tell you, right now, Dale Brown can get a knockout and win this world title in this round if he puts the pressure on Dale on O'Neal Bell.
Listen, if you've watched him during his career, you know that O'Neal Bell has gone down before. Happened against Kelvin Davis. He ended up winning that fight by TKO.
But the way
and Dale Brown is very conscious of that. He knows that Bell is capable of an instant comeback at any point. But
now.
I agree with you that his legs have not looked good here in this third round.
His knees are locked. He's on his heels. He has no balance. He goes over. There he goes again.
Right hand comes in this time. Dale Brown's able to back it up with a left.
Dale Brown right now is fighting the smartest. Oh.
Staggers him with a right hand. And Bell is trying to shake it off. Last 20 seconds here of this third round. Dale Brown on top of O'Neal Bell. Two previous times he fought for the world title. He was in that position. Now he's on top. Bell tries to fight out of the jam. Fighting is way out of the corner, digging in with body shots. But what a big, big round for Dale Brown. O'Neal Bell hurting that third round.
O'Neal, how you feeling, son? Take the knee.
Here's what happened, Kev.
We take a look. You see O'Neal's legs are really shabby right here. His legs, knees are locking right now. He's getting hit by every shot that Dale Brown's throwing. Dale Brown landing shots, grazing, glancing shots, and it seems O'Neal's not reacting right to him.
Later in that round.
As you see later in the round, you see him, Dale Brown catching with that straight right hand again. You see the legs locking on his heels as O'Neal tries to come back, looping wide shots. Dale Brown can read those shots, come up the middle and on the inside, and there go the legs buckling of O'Neal Bell. I tell you, I'm very nervous of O'Neal Bell's right now.
A lot of confidence in the corner of Dale Brown. And I'm sure up in Calgary, Canada right now, there's a lot of cheering going on with Brian Strong and the folks at NSD, the gym that he works at. They're having a big party in Calgary tonight to see if their man can bring home the IBF title.
All Brown got to keep doing is what he's doing. He ain't got to change up what he's doing. Utilize the jab, punch off the jab, and don't get careless. He just didn't get careless. He threw a lazy jab.
No, punch out of there now. No,
Friday Night Fights presented by AutoZone, coming to you from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Joe Tessitore and Kevin Kelly with you. You are watching the IBF Cruiserweight title fight. O'Neal Bell in the purple. And Dale Brown is now dealing with a second cut that is started near the left eye as a right hand comes in from O'Neal Bell. What an exciting fight it's been. Now a short right hand from Dale Brown. And it's the cut now near the left eye that is really starting to affect this fight. Look at that pump. Watch those right hands from Bell. He digs to the body, tries to go back with an overhand right. He's got a meaty target now with that cut left eye of Dale Brown. Dale Brown had O'Neal Bell hurt in that third round.
O'Neal's legs look a little bit better than they were looking before early on. His knees were locking. I don't know exactly why. His punching power is getting a little bit better now. He's getting a little bit more relaxed in the fight. His knees are bending now. I don't know what went on early in the fight, but his legs did not look right to me.
Brown puts his punches together. Now there's another right hand coming in from Bell. A lot of action here in round number four. That boxing stuff has gone out the window, Kev.
I knew it would. You know, it's almost like you watch Turo Gotti. Sometimes he tries. You wonder when he's going to start fighting again.
Dicks to the body.
And Lil Bell is trying to punch now. He's starting to come out of that pocket again.
Dale Brown isn't too shy either, Kev.
They're both
right hand, left hand. Misses that time. And O'Neal Bell says, bring it on.
Who lands last can actually land last right here. I mean, both men are punching convincingly hard. I think Dale Brown has had his moments, but not this round. He hasn't hurt O'Neal Bell any good.
Oh. Right hand comes in from Bell, and Brown goes back. Great comeback in this fourth round from O'Neal Bell. Dale Brown still very game, very active, and very much in it. But he was cut near the left eye here in this fourth round after having Bell hurt in the third round.
As a man, I'm flesh and blood. I can be destroyed. As a symbol.
22nd. Only on DirecTV.
Only.
Time! Get over there.
Look at that T-bone cut above the left eye of Dale Brown. Kevin, how did it happen? It
happened with a straight overhand right as you right there. It came down in slicing motion, and that's what ripped toward it. Cut open, wide open. Left him bleeding. Blood dripped on the side of his face. But I don't think it's in the eye, so it interferes with the fight. So we'll let it continue.
We'll monitor that. It's almost like shaped in a shape of a seven. So it's got potential to tear and open up a little worse. You see the punches in round number four, a round in which O'Neal Bell, 23 of his 24 connects were power shots. So So much for the boxing. We can put that game plan to sleep real quick.
Well,
I'm going to outbox the
his
boxer.
His legs look a lot better now. I don't know what happened early on in this fight, but his legs looked really bad early in the fight. I mean, he looked like he was trouble. I mean, was that part of a plan or something? I mean, he didn't look too healthy there.
Fires in with a lead right hand, does Bell.
Right now, there with the cowboy, he utilized the jabs. Stick back to what you used to do. Box. He's not boxing. He's not even throwing punches right about now. He's got to utilize the jab. And, of course, O'Neal Bell is throwing wide right hands. He's got to come straight down the line, like right there. We throw straight shots and move to his left or right. The cut is trickling some blood down the side of his face. And that's what the cowboy needs to do. Stay on the outside and frustrate O'Neal Bell and get him to reach for him so he can catch him coming in.
And he needs that jab to be just a touch more active here. He knew going in that that would be the game plan, to make Bell think at all times and think about that jab.
I believe that the cowboy is distracted by that cut.
And I agree, Kev.
He's not jabbing. I think he's a little nervous that O'Neal Bell's going to go over the top of that
counter,
right hand.
Counter right back to that
right
cut.
Exactly. And that's what he's nervous of.
So many things play a factor in this sweet
science. Watch the back of the head. Watch the back of the head.
Final minute here of round number five. For Dale Brown, the third time that he has stepped up and gone after a world title. For O'Neal Bell, he's been patiently awaiting this moment.
The cowboy's not throwing any jabs. He'd be better off if he jab, and then step to the right, jab, step to the left, and confuse O'Neal Bell, but instead he's staying, he's moving, but he's not punching up that movement.
Going six fewer than O'Neal Bell in terms of the jabs, according to CompuBox, and that is a stat that he cannot afford to be on the deficit. Overhand right over the top that time. Now works behind that jab, but as we come to the end of this fifth round, definitely a round in which Dale Brown has slowed. Let's see how they finish up.
Watch your head, man, all right?
We look all right?
Well, I take pain medicine for my arthritis.
She called to help.
He said, this time we did everything right when Dale Brown was asked about his training for his third chance at a world title. You can prepare all you want, but Kevin Kelly in the midst of battle, when that cut opens up and you're tested and your opponent is firing off with power, tough to prepare for that.
That changes everything. Adversity, that's an ultimate adversity. I mean, cuts, broken hands, pulled ligaments, anything can go wrong in the ring. And when it does, then you can prepare for that. I've just trained blindfolded. I've hit the bag blindfolded. I've hit the bag with closed eyes. I've hit the bag with one hand. So things happen.
Kevin Kelly's scorecard through five rounds.
Let's go.
Promise we'll get that to you soon enough.
No. The first
I got it right now.
47-47. And that's because of a 10-8 third round. For Dale Brown, that's when the big right hands came in, and O'Neal Bell was hurt.
There was no knockdown, which you say is mandatory.
No, but that 10-8. Felt like a 10-8 round, Kev.
He took a pound, and I mean, I thought O'Neal Bell was going to hit the canvas in that round, but he didn't, so I gotta give him credit. His legs has recovered. It seemed like he had a problem early on with his legs. His footing still doesn't look right, but his knees look a lot better. His legs look better, look stronger, got some strength underneath him. He's got to cut the ring off. He's just walking in on Dale Brown. Dale Brown is
this
not
is a good combination. Brown trying to escape danger after O'Neal Bell put together that combination. Three-year-old from Calgary, Canada, Dale Brown. His pace has slowed after he had O'Neal Bell in trouble.
One thing that's happened is big time is that Dale Brown is walking straight in. And he catches O'Neal Bell when he walks in. But then he throws and turn into another combination and turn again into another combination. Instead, he gets out of it.
O'Neal Bell talked about the fact that he's so impressed with Dale Brown's angles and his ability to sidestep. Brown was very complimentary to Bell in terms of his power. We've seen a bit of both exhibited tonight. Round number 6 scheduled for 12 for the IBF cruiserweight title.
Neil Brown's actually having a good round here. He's catching Neil Bell walking with some good shots. And Neil Bell is walking around getting killed with shots, not cutting the ring off.
Halfway through on Friday Night Fights, presented by AutoZone.
All right, back here in our Friday Night Fight studios. Again, Sugar Shane Mosley with us all night. What do you think of this fight, Shane?
I think it's a great fight. It's an action-packed fight.
All right, what do you think? Dale Brown hanging in there tough. Do you think he catches him with one of those right hands, or do you think eventually Bell wears him down and walks him down?
Well, I think Bell is doing a great job. Now, I give Bell a little more rounds than Brown. But it's a great fight. I think that maybe he might get him with a good right hand or whatever.
All right, again, Shane Mosley with us throughout the night. We're going to send it back to Joe Tessitore and the Flushing Flash. Kevin, what do you think about that?
Well, the way I see it, like right now with the fight, it's looking like, you know, Dale Brown, when he boxes, he's boxing something on the outside. He's looking pretty good. Straight right hand, Bell is looking for a big punch, looking for one shot to knock out Brown. But it could happen, only if Dale Brown stops long enough in front of him.
Kevin McDermott, the trainer for Dale Brown, told his charge after that 6th round, he's slowing down, is O'Neal Bell. You need to jab, jab, jab some more, and then you'll see everything coming a lot easier. Of course, 39 jabs in that 6th round. That's the high in the fight for Brown. Early on, it was his power punches that were doing the damage, so he stayed more with that, especially in the 3rd round when he had O'Neal Bell hurt.
Phil Brown right now is doing an excellent boxing job on O'Neal Bell. Right now, O'Neal Bell punches a little bit wide. He's going the outside of Phil Brown. Phil Brown throwing straight shots down the middle. He's catching O'Neal Bell with some good shots. O'Neal Bell's balance is not exactly that good right now. And Dale Brown right now is boxing O'Neal Bell very well. He's doing very well this round. I got it scored unofficially, of course, 56-57. I got O'Neal losing by 1 point. Of course, the early rounds, I thought that he was taking a beating early. And he came back into the fight, but he's not busy with his jab. He's not cutting the ring off on Dale Brown at all. He's just walking in. He's getting hit with shots as he walks in. And Brown's confidence is getting better.
Let's go, come on.
On the inside is where Brown wants to stay away from. There's the work at range with the jab. And even if it's not landing, it's still effective just by fighting his controlled and his pace style fight. Overhand looping right. It may be awkward, but at times effective from O'Neal Bell.
Yeah, but it's one punch, and I don't know if it's enough for those combinations that he's getting hit with. I mean, it's one punch in the whole round. He landed one shot, but I'm pretty sure that Dale Brown's landing percentage right now is at its height. He's landing very good jabs. He's got O'Neal Bell at the end of his punches. He's landing combination after combination since this round started. Here you go again. Lands. You know, he's not hitting with sufficient of hard shots to stop O'Neal Bell, but they are landing. And there it goes, right there. Right there, O'Neal Bell got hit with a counter. You know, I mean, what do you think of that one? Dale Brown is getting back into this fight with his boxing, and O'Neal Bell is waiting on the outside. He's a recipient of those punches.
This is by far the best round we've seen out of Dale Brown since that 3rd round, when it was the powerful right hand that had hurt Dale Brown. Strong effort, volume, and efficiency from Dale Brown's short right hand.
Here we take a look at the counterpuncher by Dale Brown. When O'Neal Bell gets sloppy, he gets caught. And that's him getting sloppy right there, and that's him getting hit and countered.
Round number 8, IBF Cruiserweight title on the line. O'Neal Bell in the purple trunks. Dale Cowboy
low
Brown,
down,
the cagey veteran. His 3rd shot at a world title.
Busy, Dale.
Will he hit the jackpot tonight?
Well, I got him winning right now, 67-65.
Left hand down, you gotta box him.
Unofficially, of course, you know, he's doing pretty good. When he boxes, he does very well. He keeps O'Neal Bell, and he's punching first and punching last. And O'Neal Bell is just sitting out there waiting for the telegram because, okay, throw a punch. And he throws wide and wild, and his punches come behind the head of Dale Brown. So right now, I got Dale Brown winning by 2 points. Unofficially, of course, but you know, O'Neal Bell is throwing one shot at a time.
38%. The CompuBox numbers from round number 7. A very, very strong round for Dale Brown. Let's visit with his trainer, Kevin McDermott. Kevin, keep listening in between rounds, and I hear you say time and time again, he's getting frustrated. He's getting frustrated.
Let your hands go, Dale. That's right. That's right. He is. We just want to keep, what we'll do what Bell can do, and that's box.
All right, let's go. Punch out of there.
Been
now.
Doing that well the past two rounds. 73 jabs in total, landing 19. How key is the jab, Kevin?
It's the key to this whole fight. It keeps the right hand off. When he throws the right hand, it blocks the right hand, and it backs O'Neal back up onto his back foot.
Will, do you think you're ahead in this fight? And if so, will you tell Dale?
No, I'm not going to tell him he's ahead. Not yet, anyway. I do believe he's ahead. Good, that's
good combination.
It, Dale. Move your feet and move now.
Kevin, give us a glimpse of what you'll tell him after this 8th round.
I'm going to wait and see what happens for the rest of the round here.
What do you think? Do you think that Dale can knock out O'Neal Bell?
We are not. We're just looking at outboxing O'Neal Bell.
But are you realizing the legs of O'Neal Bell doesn't look right?
We know what's going on. We've already told him he's slowing down.
Kevin McDermott, fine trainer of Dale Brown. Thank you very
nice.
Much.
Come on, Dale. Second attack. Jab, jab, jab. Come on, Dale. Get the left hand going. Yes.
Good score by Dale Brown. Final minute of 8th round. He is working his game plan precisely.
All that work in Vegas has done him good. I can see. He's only problem that he's doing, he's stepping out of range. He's got O'Neal Bell's legs reacting the same way as they react in the third round. You see O'Neal Bell's legs. His legs are locking. He's on his heels. He's walking right into shots. It's very dangerous for O'Neal Bell right now.
But another strong round for Dale Brown. He is looking sharp as we come to the stretch run.
Hey!
Friday Night Fights presented by AutoZone from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Kevin Kelly. And if you like watching dreams come true, then stick around for these next 4 rounds because somebody's will. And if Dale Brown in the black with red stays the course and gives his trainer Kevin McDermott what he asked for, the best 4 rounds of his life, then the long-awaited championship of the world will be around his waist.
Right now, I don't think Bell has any answers for what Dale Brown is doing. He's getting out jabs, he's getting out hustles, he's getting out blocks, he's getting out counterpunch. There's nothing that O'Neal Bell is doing right now that's helping him.
The CompuBox stats proved that true in that 8th round. He had 8 connects, did O'Neal Bell. That was his low total in the fight. And only threw 38 punches. That's just not enough work. 77-75 on Kevin Kelly's scorecard in favor of Dale Brown, the likable veteran from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. O'Neal Bell still searching for answers on the inside.
He's frustrated. He's reaching. Right now, he doesn't have a game plan together right now. He does do lots of jab. He's going to get back to his jab, O'Neal Bell. The way to get a knockout is you got to come out of jab. He's throwing one punch at a time. See his balance? He throws the right hand, and he almost turns southpaw, and he's off balance, and he can't recover. And that's why O'Neal Bell's having so much trouble. He's a one-punch fighter. Overhand right, that's all he has. And he's getting walking into every punch that Cowboy's throwing. It's the only moments he has. It's right there. The Cowboy gives him moments. That's it. Other than that, the Cowboy's on the outside, boxing real successful. And like I said, one thing you can't forget about O'Neal Bell, he can punch with either hand.
You know, O'Neal Bell, you could make the argument, was potentially overconfident coming into this fight. A fight that he thought he'd have in February for the IBF belt against
right,
Kelvin Davis. A fight
let's
in which
go.
He went as far as to bring in Eric Buxton, his old high school wrestling coach, to work his corner as his cut man. A sign of overconfidence?
Well, you know, I asked his cut man in the meeting about what to use, amoxicillin, the 1000 solution, all that stuff, and he didn't know. And thank God that... The cut that Dale Brown has, O'Neal's lucky that he don't have that cut.
Yeah, and cuts aside, it just signals to you that this is a guy that was very confident, so much so that he could use a cut man for nothing more than inspiration. End of round number 9.
At AutoZone, I can find the right part.
Secrets, new inspirations at Olive Garden.
Round number 10, scheduled for 12 with the IBF title on the line between these veteran cruiserweights, O'Neal Bell and Dale Cowboy Brown. Power punches through round 9, a category in which O'Neal Bell should be dominating. Bell landed 39%, and he had the biggest punch of the fight in the third round with a right hand that had O'Neal Bell hurt. Joe Tessitore and Kevin Kelly. Ringside with you as Dale Brown trying to box his way to a world title. O'Neal Bell searching for answers with the power that he's been known for. 22 knockouts out of his 23 wins. Gave many of the middle rounds away as Bell settled into steady work with the jab and smart boxing. Let's now bring in Sugar Shane Mosley, the 3-time world champion. Shane, why is this fight going the way it's going?
I think it's going the way it's going because Bell's just kind of following him around the ring. Bell's following Brown around the ring and is being able to be outboxed. But I think it's a close fight there.
Shane, don't you see here that right now that Dale Brown, for some strange reason, decides to lay in front of O'Neal Bell and let O'Neal Bell work?
Well, as you see right there, he caught him in a great left hook. I think he figured out that Bell's don't have as much steam on his punches anymore, and he's trying to get that good left hook in there.
So you think Bell is slowing down?
I think Bell is slowing down a little bit. He's overexerting himself to try to get that knockout, and I don't think he has the same steam on his punches as he had once in the early rounds.
Shane Mosley doing a great job tonight. Thank you very much. They look to trade here in the final minute of this 10th round. Short right hand on the inside from Brown. O'Neal Bell. He may be desperate, but he's capable. He has gotten off the floor before. He's come back to win by knockout before. He's been behind on the scorecards before. He'll need to do that here, most likely, against Dale Brown as we enter the championship rounds. Last 30 seconds of this 10th round.
Come on.
Two cuts that Dale Brown has been dealing with all night. The one in the center of the forehead has not played a factor. And the left eye, that was streaming, but now that's under control. He placed a good uppercut. The championship rounds coming up on Friday Night Fights, presented by AutoZone. Friday Night Fights from Hollywood, Florida. And will we have a Hollywood-type ending to this cruiserweight title bout? O'Neal Bell, Dale Brown, round number 11. O'Neal Bell showed glimpses in that 10th round, Kevin. That was a tough round to score. Do you think he's got enough left?
I scored it dead even. I kind of gave O'Neal Bell the first half of the round and the Cowboy the second part of the round. But right now, Dale Brown is doing away with O'Neal Bell right now in this round. He's landing but more effective shots. I think O'Neal Bell might have shot his last load the last round, and he looks very tired, his mouth's open.
O'Neal Bell in his career has 3 knockouts in the 11th round. He knows when to turn it on, but will he be able to turn it on against the smart boxer who is so determined, the 33-year-old Dale Brown? The third time he stepped up and has tried to win a cruiserweight title belt. He swears this time will be different. So far, it has been. He was stopped in his previous 2 attempts to win the title. The last 2 rounds, the punch stats. Bell, 48 out of 162. Brown, a little more judicious, 39 out of 121. Defense to the body much better than in the past, does Dale Brown. We saw it right there.
He's blocking much better.
Derrick Brown right now, see his energy levels up. He's going to win the championship rounds right now. He's trying to win them. He's definitely trying to win them right now. He's got Anil Bell backing up. His power's not working. He's not getting off any punches. He just got caught. Derrick Brown caught him with a left hook to the face. And I tell you, the judge is definitely watching this action right now. And he's got Anil Bell against the ropes.
Nels is standing against the ropes, inviting him in. Now he tries to come off. Short right hand, 1-2.
Stop punching, step back, stop punching. Let's go, get the mouthpiece.
I have to question Anil Bell's conditioning. I think that something either psychologically or something physically is bothering him. And he looks very tired, fatigued. He expected to get a knockout early or something because he looks very tired, very lethargic.
I hearken back to the overconfidence. This was a hungry Dale Brown that left his beautiful wife and two children behind in Calgary to go to Vegas for a long training camp. Meanwhile, O'Neal Bell, we touched on it. Maybe it was a sign, bringing in his high school wrestling coach to work his corner as a cutman. Maybe a sign of overconfidence as he's pushed back from another stiff jab from Dale Brown. They will have one round to go to determine the IBF Cruiserweight Championship of the World.
Okay, look.
We need this round, man. You're boxing beautiful, Dale. Let me see your glove.
You don't have to hold up with a spinner back, okay? What a spinner back,
Dale, the last 3 minutes to your dream, buddy. You've got to keep your hands moving.
Busy.
And the
rest of your life.
Yeah.
One round the rest of your life. You got all night to breathe. Don't let him breathe this round.
You got to go quick.
All right,
come on.
We can do it.
All right, let's go. Put that water up. Come on.
The 12th and final round. It has come down to this.
We can fight a little bit.
We appreciate your time. We appreciate your efforts. You always give a great effort. Thank you very much. Dale Brown. So that wraps up our evening from Hollywood, Florida. The corner of Dale Brown. They've been with him for a long time. They know how hard he works. And as you heard them say, it's the last 3 minutes to your dream. One round for the rest of your life. The same can be said for O'Neal Bell. The problem is many of those rounds are now in the rearview mirror in a fight that he was not primed throughout.
Right now, I got Dale Brown winning on the my scorecards unofficially, of course, 105-103. Right now, O'Neal Bell is desperate. He needs a knockout to win on my scorecards. And if Dale Brown boxes successfully, I think he'll be world champion walking out with the IBF belt around his waist.
Fights past 11. Dale Brown has been here three times. O'Neal Bell, we told you, he's knocked out three opponents in the 11th round. So some uncharted waters for O'Neal Bell. The 12th round, he's never seen.
Well, right now, Nobel is very sloppy. He's still trying to get to Dale Brown, punching very wide. And that's the first combination that O'Neal Bell landed, and he threw it straight. But he got counterpunched. He got hit in turn. So right now, Dale Brown's doing an excellent boxing job on O'Neal Bell.
Let's go. Come on. Stop punching. Step
back. I
want
to remind you that coming up next is Somos ESPN Deportes. That's coming up after this cruiserweight title fight. A two-time world title challenger was Dale Brown. He never knew if he would get this opportunity again, but he won five straight. He worked his way back, and he rededicated him to a sport that has been his life's passion. And if these judges see it the way this crowd has and the way we have, he should be 1 minute away from calling himself a world champion. To the body. Now Bell digs in. Still searching for answers on the inside. A place that he should have had the advantage all night long.
Bell's legs still don't look right in this last round. I believe that it seemed like Dale Brown, every time he hits him, We get a kind of reaction. I mean, there goes a good
short left hand. Good shot from the Cowboy.
Let's go. Come on. Stop punching. Step back.
Last 20 seconds. Mouthpiece has hit the canvas. Armando Garcia's letting it go. O'Neal Bell needs something here. Dale Brown, 10 seconds for the rest of your life. It was worthy of being called a championship fight. Dale Brown, his best effort at this level we have seen in his entire career. O'Neal Bell had his moments, but Dale Brown, he may have his moments when we come back. We will hear the judges' scores when we return to Friday Night Fights presented by AutoZone. We may soon have a Cinderella man here at the Seminole Hard Rock in Hollywood, Florida. O'Neal Bell, Dale Brown, the total punches with the IBF Cruiserweight title on the line. The Cowboy, 218 to 185. He had a 29-17 advantage in that last round with 26 power connects. Kevin Kelly had it 116 to 112. I had it 9-3 for Dale Brown. Let's see what Damian Pinto has to say. Who's the new IBF champ?
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for both of these warriors right here? Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecards, and here are your scores. Judge Michael Pernick scores this fight 115 to 113. Judge Robert Hoyle scores this fight 116 to 112. And Judge Rich Green sees it at 117 to 111. All three judges scoring in favor of your winner by unanimous decision and new IBF Cruiserweight Champion of the World, O'Neal.
Whoa.
Give him
hell. I am telling you right now.
Oh, my goodness.
I am telling you right now. You got to be kidding me with 117, 111. And I totally disagree altogether.
Totally, totally disagree. I had it 115, 112. I saw Dale Brown win that fight. I know,
and you know what?
I saw.
O'Neal Bell's going to come down. We're going to interview him, and I'm going to tell him that flat out.
I'll tell him I thought you lost, and I saw you lose the fight. I know what I saw. I'm very honest with the fight. He did not win this fight tonight.
This is a guy that was hurt so badly, you had to score it a 10-8 third round, did you not? He was outboxed throughout the middle rounds, and the CompuBox numbers strongly favored Dale Brown. That is just unbelievable. But then again, we are in the state of Florida that doesn't have a Herculean state commission. We'll try to sort this thing out. The bottom line is O'Neal Bell is the new IBF Cruiserweight Champion. Let's send it back to the studio to Brian Penny and Sugar Shane.
All right, now I know why Joe and Kevin are all that upset. Shane, you and I are up there. We're scoring the fight, too. Yeah. And now you had it 116-112 for Dale Brown.
For Dale Brown,
That said, I mean, I'm not outraged by it. In that 117-111, I agree, is a little far skewed. But what are your thoughts on the decision here?
Well, there's a couple of rounds that could have went either way. But, you know, you never know. I mean, I viewed it 116-112, and I'm watching it on the TV. It could have been a different story, a different something different in the actual auditorium where you have a different view,
right,
different angle. But I see Dale Brown win the fight.
Yeah, I thought he won, too. And yet, while we're watching the fight, we're talking about it here. I said, don't be shocked if a few of these rounds could go right over the other way. Maybe O'Neal Bell looking at, you know, heavier hands, as you say. You hear that whacking on the body of Dale Brown. Maybe they go back the other way. I know why Joe and Teddy, and Kevin are all riled up about it. But again, I can see why O'Neal Bell may have won that fight, although 117-111, I agree with Joe.
Maybe a draw.
Was a little off. A draw wouldn't have stunned me at all. All right, let's talk about the welterweight picture right now. Zab Judah is the welterweight champion. He just knocked out Cosme Rivera. What do you think of Zab? What about you and Zab somewhere in the future?
Well, I think Zab is a great fighter, and you know, he looked very well, very good against Cosme Rivera. Although, I mean, Cosme Rivera came in the ring at 147. He weighed in 146, came in the ring at 147. Zab came in the ring at 151. So they were both very small for the welterweight division.
Right.
Maybe someday in the near future, maybe in November, October, me and Zab can get on. I'd like to take one more fight and. We can talk about it.
Yeah, tell you, Rivera somehow, I even asked, our own guys on .com, the guys at Ring, how did Rivera get into the top 10? Or is Zab Judah, just that powerful now in the welterweight class that he just takes a guy out this easily? You tell me. Has he gotten that much better?
Well, I mean, he has a lot of speed, and he's brung up his power into the division. But like I said, it didn't seem like there were real welterweights in there. The guy comes in the ring at 147. That's a junior welterweight to me.
All right, what are your plans? What do you want done in the next year?
Well, I would like to have a fight sometime, maybe in July, August. That'd be great. If I can, then maybe get the fight, maybe in, December or January with one of the fighters, either Margarito, Zab Judah. I mean, De La Hoya is talking about fighting. There's all kind of possibilities out there.
You'll always be there for Oscar, right? If Oscar comes back and says, you know what, Shane, I know I can beat you. I want to do it one more time. What do you say?
I said, let's do it.
Let's do it. All right. What about Antonio Margarito? Have there been negotiations? You read things on the .com sites? Anything?
There haven't been any negotiations with me and Margarito whatsoever. I think, I don't know who put that press out there. I haven't heard anything. I heard it on the press saying that was offered $1.1 million to take a fight with Margarito. Never heard anything. I don't think I would take $1.1 million anyway to fight a Margarito. But, I would definitely fight anybody in the welterweight division, and I will fight anybody in the welterweight division.
All right, Shane, it was great having you here on the program. Thank you so much. Great having you. Sugar Shane Mosley with us tonight. We wish you the best of luck. We'll see you. We'll be following you very closely. We want to send it back out now to Joe and Kevin. They're with the winner. They don't agree with the winner, but they have the winner, O'Neal Bell. Guys?
Ryan Kenny, thank you very much. Congratulations, O'Neal. You are the new IBF Cruiserweight Champion of the world. I'm going to let you know flat out, I thought you lost the fight fairly convincingly.
Very convincing. Why is that?
I actually do. Kevin and I both had you on the opposite side. I congratulate you all we could.
So what did you think?
I thought that you were hurt in the third round and completely off box in the middle rounds. You gave a very game effort, as you always do. You're always capable with your power punching. But we felt both the CompuBox numbers showed it and what was shown in the ring that you did not win this fight.
I showed resilience. You know, he hurt me. I came back. I was the aggressor in the fight. You know, I was the aggressive fight. I can't take nothing from him. He outboxed me in a sense, but I was the aggressor. I busted him up. Look at him, chin, head, eyes, and everything. You tell me I lost the fight.
I agree. You busted him up.
I was the aggressor. He couldn't take it.
Well, one thing I think you ought to go over and watch the footage.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone who got me here. Most of all, the Most High. Without him, I wouldn't get there. Without him, I still wouldn't get here.
Well, you're a wonderful professional. I'm not taking that away from you. You know how much I respect you, and I do congratulate you. But we had it the other way.
Kevin. I had it scored 115, 112 in the fight. A lot of the early rounds, I thought you lost early rounds. I gave you four rounds out of the 12 rounds. I scored it, the studio scored it, Shane scored it. We all thought that you did lose the fight. You're watching it on tape. I know right now it's kind of hard to tell if you won or lost because you was in there. I know. I'm a fighter.
Bottom line is you did win.
But you won the title.
Yes, I did.
In the
world. Yes, I did.
Are you going to give him a rematch?
Now I would defend. I told him he's a very good boxer. I said anytime he wants a rematch, he has it. But let me go after Mormon, top of them. Then I'll show you who the real champion is. You know
O'Neal,
what I'm saying?
Congratulations.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, let's bring in Dale Cowboy Brown, who was stepping up to the plate for the third time for a world title. Dale, I assume you just heard what we said. Brian Kenny, Shane Mosley, Kevin Kelly, and I all scored this fight for you.
You know what, I thought I worked harder, but having said that, guys, I can always work harder. I heard O'Neal say busting me up. Look, I got a headbutt underneath the chin, one right hand to the eye. Yeah, he cut me some big shots, but he did not bust me up, trust me. One or two shots, this fight looks totally different. He cut me with one shot, man, he didn't bust me up.
How come you didn't go? I mean, at times, I thought his legs looked really, really bad. I mean, they looked like you could take him out on serious points. Why didn't you go for the knockout?
You know what? I did, and I was looking for it. I went back to the corner. I thought I was getting a little bit too wide, Kevin. I was swinging my punches. I should have been pit, 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 looking for a big fourth, fifth shot. But I was looking for one big shot because I saw I hurt him behind the ear a couple times, on the jaw a couple times. But then I was trying to load up with the big shot. I should have went pat, pat, and then load up on a big one.
Why did you step? I mean, there was times where you landed a good combination. You had him buckled. You had him hurt. And instead of applying more pressure and throwing the combinations, you stepped off him. I believe that's what hurt you in the fight.
Absolutely. Guaranteed. It hurt me. If I kept sustained pressure, and like I said, just pit, 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 move my head. I didn't move my head half as much as I should have this fight.
But you moved your hands. That's why I thought you had the victory.
I appreciate that. You know what? I thought it was a good fight. Hats off to O'Neal. He's a tough tough guy. And like he said in the ring, he says he wants to give me a rematch, and I'm game. I think I can take that off.
Dale, just quickly, what was your reaction when those scores were being read?
You know what? When they said 115-113, you know what? I thought I had the fight.
When they said 117-111,
yeah, that's a little bit crazy. You know, it was a good fight. I think it was a good cruiserweight fight. And it just gives kudos to the cruiserweight division where we can fight a little bit.
We appreciate your time. We appreciate your efforts. You always give a great effort. Thank you very much. Dale Brown.
So that wraps up our evening from Hollywood, Florida.